Hi everyone, Captain Cosmo here. Welcome back to episode 3 of our online holiday club Space Academy. We really hope that you are enjoying it so far and learning lots about Daniel and everything that happened in his story. Today I have another fun fact for you. Now I want you to have a think about all of the planets. Maybe you could see if you could name a few just whilst you're watching this now. And I wonder if you'd be able to guess what the hottest planet is. I'll tell you. The hottest planet in our solar system has temperatures of up to 461 degrees Celsius. That is over twice as hot as the hottest possible setting on your oven at home. And the planet that gets that hot is Venus. There you go. A nice fun fact that you can share with your friends and family. Isn't that amazing? You just can't even imagine how unbelievably hot that must be. It gets hotter because it has a thick yellow cloud above in the atmosphere, and it acts like a greenhouse, so it traps all the heat in, so there's nowhere for the gas to escape to. That's why it gets so hot. That's really cool. Now obviously we're going to share the next part of the story of Daniel with you today, and there's a reason that our fun fact for today has got something to do with heat. Now we've got some special guests helping us tell the story today, so have a little watch of this.
Hi there, welcome to the Space Academy Starship. I'm Captain Stu. Today's story is about Daniel's three friends, Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. They woke up early one morning and saw something stunning. It looked like it had come from another planet. Oh, no, not you, Ringo. It was a huge statue built by King Neb's builder at his command. It was 27 metres tall, 3 metres wide, and all made of gold.
Well, actually, Captain.
What is that? What is it, Lieutenant Max?
Actually, it wouldn't have been covered in gold, as there wouldn't have been enough gold in Babylon for it to have been solid gold. But still pretty impressive.
Thank you, Lieutenant. A huge gold-covered statue indeed.
To give you an idea of the size, Captain, the Angel of the North near Newcastle is in England is only 20 metres high, 7 metres shorter than King Neb's statue.
That's impressive. Right, Dr. Charlotte?
Uh-huh.
When the statue was finished, King Neb gave orders for everyone in the kingdom to come to a ceremony. The King Herald announced when the music played, everyone must bow down and worship the statue, or they would be thrown into a blazing furnace.
Ooh, that's not good.
King Neb had not remembered what he'd already learnt about Daniel's God being the greatest.
But now he's telling everyone to worship a statue he's made himself.
The king's announcement was very bad news for Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. They were friends of God and wanted to do what he said.
We've already seen how they stood up for God by eating just vegetables back in episode 1.
Yes, the second of God's commandments said they were not to worship any other gods. But what could they do? Then the king signalled the musicians to start playing. And when they did, all the people bowed down, apart from Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. Now, there were some troublemakers in the crowd who wanted to get Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego into trouble, so they reported them to the king. What? The king shouted out in anger. I'll give you one more chance. If you bow down when the music starts, then fine. If not, it's the furnace for you. Start the music. Again, Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego refused to go down. Do you think there is any god who can save you? The king asked them. They replied, the god we worship can save us from you and the flaming furnace. But even if he doesn't, we still won't worship the gold statue.
What an amazing thing to say.
This made King Neb very angry, and his face turned red. He ordered the furnace to be heated up 7 times hotter than usual. He told the strongest men from his army to tie up Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego and threw them in.
The furnace was so hot that the soldiers got burnt up as they threw the 3 men in.
Then the king jumped up. What? He shouted. I thought we threw 3 men in the fire. There are 4 of them now, walking around in the fire, and the 4th one, he looks like a god. King Neb called the 3 men out of the blazing fire, and everyone crowded around them. They were not burnt, their hair wasn't scorched, and their clothes didn't even smell of smoke.
Wow!
Now that's not humanly possible.
King Neb told everyone to praise the god of Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. He realised that their god was the greatest, and he'd never known a god who could rescue quite like this. So once again, Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego are rescued from death. But what other strange goings on are there going to be in Babylon? Find out next time. Back to Jess.
Bye! Bye.
Wow! Wasn't that an amazing story? Can you imagine how Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego might have felt in that situation? I wonder if we've ever been in a situation where we're having to stand up to something that we believe in. Have we ever had to stand up in such a way that it risks everything? Imagine having that much trust and that much faith. I think that's just incredible. I wonder what it must have been like as well to see this statue. Have you ever been to a museum or a gallery and seen a statue? Sometimes we have them in towns and cities, there's just statues around. Perhaps next time you see a statue, you can have a really good look at it and maybe remember parts of this story. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you for this story of faith, this amazing faith shown by Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. Lord, we pray that you can help us to have this same faith, to stand up for those things that we believe in, even when that means big risks and things being really difficult. Thank you that you are faithful and that you keep your promises and you protect us. In Jesus' name, amen. Again, if you would like to join in with some action songs, there'll be a couple of new ones available on our website next to this episode as well. And you can find that at www.exmooryouthproject.com. There's also the downloadable worksheet available again for episode 3. So if you'd like to do that, then you can. And our craft suggestion for today is to make gingerbread men. Now, we've put a recipe online on our website as well. And if you watch the next bit of the video, you can see us having a go at making some gingerbread. So hopefully there's a few things for you to go away with to do today. We hope you enjoyed this next part of the story of Daniel, and we look forward to seeing you in the next episode where you can find out a little bit more. Thank you. Bye. Hello everyone. For today's craft idea, we thought that we could have a go at making gingerbread men to try and remember the story of Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. So we've got a couple of different sized gingerbread cutters ready to go, and Eli's got our mixing bowl already, so we're going to put all of our ingredients in there and mix it all up, ready to roll out and cut our gingerbread men out of. Yeah, so we've put all of our dry ingredients in a bowl, and Eli's just going to help me mix that all together. That's it, ready for all of our wet stuff to go in so we can mould it into our gingerbread dough. Okay, so Now we've mixed up all of our ingredients together, all the wet stuff and the dry stuff, and we've got our gingerbread dough all ready. Eli's already rolled his out. There, look. And he's about to cut out some gingerbread men, ready to go in the oven, and I'm going to do mine too. And hopefully we can show you the finished product in a minute. So we've cut out some of our gingerbread men and they're going to go in the oven to cook. So hopefully in a few minutes they'll be ready to cool down, and then maybe later we can eat them. So our gingerbread are all cooked. I'm just going to take them out of the oven. There we go, some finished gingerbread men. So our house smells amazing now that we've made all of that gingerbread. And if you'd like to do that craft activity as well, the recipe that we use will be on our website next to this video. If you don't have the stuff in your house at the moment to make gingerbread men, because obviously we know that the shops are running out of things, don't worry, we'll keep the recipe on there, we'll keep this video online so that you can do it in a few weeks' time when maybe the stock's a bit higher in the shops and things. And if not, if you don't want to make gingerbread men, that's absolutely fine as well. Perhaps you can mould some men out of Play-Doh, or you can draw some, or you can draw a picture of what the story meant to you and the bits that you can remember. So we hope that there's a few ideas there to keep you going. I'm off to eat my gingerbread men now. Bye.